Hello, everybody!
Welcome to what will be the last 3 Days Grace review that I'll be doing for the foreseeable future until they release something new, because today I am going to be reviewing their 6th and most recent album, Outsider, from 2018. Will you love me and lead me forever? Will you love me and lead me forever? Will you love me and lead me forever? So here we are, all up to date with this fudging brilliant band. So, Outsider is the 6th album from 3 Days Grace and the 2nd so far to feature Matt Walsh as Adam Gonti's replacement. And the track list is as follows. Right, Left, Wrong, The Mountain, I Am an Outsider, Infrared, Nothing to Lose But You, Me Against You, Love Me or Leave Me, Strange Days, Villain I'm Not, Chasing the First Time, The New Real, and The Abyss. Now, throughout this video, I'll be talking about some of the things that I like about this album, as well as, of course, the criticisms that I have about it, some of which sort of carry over from my previous album review, because I think that both this and the last album do share some faults, which I'll elaborate on in a bit. Now, remember in the last review that I said Human was this band's weakest album? Well, personally, I think Outsider is a slight step upwards. While there were a few songs from Human that I really liked, the majority of them ended up feeling like a somewhat diluted attempt at retreading what was successful back in the 1X days. It was also a pretty repetitive and underwhelming experience for the most part. I mean, it was still a pretty okay album, and I'd rather listen to 50 mediocre 3 Days Grace albums than listen to a single second of whatever the fuck is on the charts right now. Anyway, Outsider has a much more lively and fast-paced feel to it, and I don't find my eyes glazing over much like last time. So on one hand, it keeps my attention better, but on the other hand, I find that another problem has been created that brings back some of the repetitiveness of the previous album. By being so energetic and in-your-face all throughout, the songs start to blend together into this weird mass of noise that sort of starts to lose any and all distinguishable features as the album goes on. Basically, it's gone from one extreme to the next. Instead of being too dull and unremarkable, it's become too hyperactive and a little less unremarkable, but still within the range of kind of bland... You get what I mean. Essentially, it tries too hard to keep your attention. It's like a long-running cartoon. Won't name any specifically, but there's plenty to choose from that fit the analogy that I'm about to fumble out of my mouth. In these cartoons, there's the beloved older episodes that are paced perfectly with slow and fast moments all meshed together in a seamless fashion, and they have no problem holding the attention of young kids and adults alike. But after a while, the people behind the production changes, things get watered down and simplified to sometimes insulting levels. Now that once beloved cartoon has become nothing more than 11 minutes of bright, fast-moving colours and obnoxious, loud noises and screaming in a vain attempt to hold the attention of dumb little kids who can't concentrate on something for more than 3 seconds, because people today are total idiots with no attention spans whatsoever. That's kind of what happened with Outsider. Where Human was generally too much of the slower, angsty songs, Outsider is too much of the upbeat, energetic songs. There doesn't seem to be any or very little mix between these two things like there was back in the older albums, and I think the newer stuff suffers because of it. Some tracks still have the issue of repetitive lyrics as well, such as Chasing the First Time, Nothing to Lose But You, and Me Against You. Also, funnily enough, Love Me or Leave Me is about 90% the line, Will You Love Me or Leave Me Forever, practically on a damn loop. But for some reason, the overall sound of that track just sounds really nice to me, so I actually give it a pass on that front. But there's really no excuse for those other songs. A lot of the themes and messages of the album are also pretty basic and surface level. Even on some of my favourite songs from the album, I can't deny this. This is also the album with the shortest runtime of them all so far from this band, even shorter than Human. There's a good few songs on here that either don't make or just about scrape 3 minute mark, which to me shows that there really is too much time spent going at breakneck speeds and not enough winding down time on some tracks. And it's a little concerning when you consider these songs would be even shorter if they cut down the repeated lyrics. It's like they can't come up with enough engaging content to fill out an average album duration, or it has something to do with people's ever-diminishing attention spans. Now, the majority of my favourite songs from this album come near the beginning, and I think the reason for me liking it at the start but gradually feeling disengaged is due to the album growing tonally stale as it goes on. This is, again, caused by the fact that almost every song is a fast-paced noise fest. A more energetic, funky sound may have been novel at first, especially after the more drab tones of the last album, but it starts to wear off around the midway point and it just becomes a bland, massive, loud noise. A lot of the tracks seem to stay on roughly the same level with not much variation in tone, no rising or falling mood, and this limits the emotional range for me at least. Despite all this, I think Outsider does still have some good things to offer. I definitely enjoyed and remembered more songs than I did from Human, and there are a couple of exceptions to the overly fast pace that I've been taking an issue to. Mainly Love Me or Leave Me and The Abyss, which is a great closing track I think. The Mountain is a fun song that I really enjoyed despite it being kinda basic. I Am an Outsider is a bit more stripped back, and I find it quite relatable. Infrared is easily one of the best songs from the whole album, if not the best. It also has my favourite line from the whole album, which is, "If you fall into me, I fall into you." Villain I'm Not is a fun one that I really vibe with for some reason as well, so that's a nice point. And overall, I think this album at least has value in a more casual sense, should we say. It's the sort of album I put on in the background while doing other stuff rather than sitting down to get immersed in it. That's usually how I listen to this one anyway. Now let's get my favourite showcase done and do the final verdict. So, all in all, considering the good and bad points, I'm gonna give Outsider 3 mountains out of 5. Like I said, it's better used as casual listening material in my opinion, and I do think there's potential for 3 Days Grace to continue with this sort of style in the future, but they really need to fix a few things to really make it work better. Namely, less lyric repetition and more tone variety. I prefer them to do that than keep trying to recapture the sound of the Golden Era and miss the mark like they did with Human. And that concludes the 3 Days Grace album reviews on this channel for the time being. When the band starts releasing new content, I'll make sure to do a review of it. But until then, I'm going to shift to reviewing the albums of Saintasonia next, which is the band that Adam Gontier helped form after his departure from 3 Days Grace. Fingers crossed I get around to reviewing at least their first album before the end of the year, am I right? Well, leave a like if you enjoyed, subscribe if you haven't already, and comment your thoughts on Outsider if you think you have any thoughts that you feel are worth typing out for people to read, that is. I'll be back with another video fairly soon, at least by my standards. So until then, enjoy the internet, you rice pudding gulping people.